Does Bible contain facts or statements which are opposed to each other? Well, it may seem to be so. In the Holy Bible, there are several instances where entirely or partially opposed things are stated. Today, we deal with one such instance related to Saint Joseph. In the genealogy of Jesus, according to Saint Matthew, Jacob is the father of Saint Joseph. But in the Gospel of Saint Luke, Haley is named as the father of Saint Joseph. How come a man can have two fathers even when biologically it is not possible? Is Jacob the same person as Haley? Let us go a little deeper. Among the scholars, there exist different opinions regarding this. According to one set of scholars, Jacob and Haley were siblings. Haley is considered by them as Saint Joseph's father by affinity, as Haley married Joseph's mother when Jacob died without providing a child, as per the Jewish custom then. According to another school of scholars, the true and legitimate father of Saint Joseph was Jacob, according to Matthew's gospel as we saw earlier, and legally and by affinity, Haley was Saint Joseph's father, as per Saint Luke. Haley is none other than the glorious Saint Joachim, the father of Queen of Heaven. Haley, Eliakim, and Joachim are synonyms for the same name in the scripture. So, Luke gives that Joseph was of Haley, not by birth, but by affinity, that is, as his son-in-law, and it is usual to express the relationship thus. In this way, we actually trace the genealogy of Mary indirectly without departing from the Hebrew custom, which never gives the genealogy on the woman's side. This also shows that Jesus belongs to his grandfather Joachim, as they are connected by blood relationship. Both Joseph and Mary belong to the glorious tribe of Judah. Joseph is a direct descendant from David through Solomon and Mary through Nathan. The first book of Chronicles, chapter 3, verse 5, clearly gives that both Solomon and Nathan were David's son from Bathsheba. Joseph's genealogy is glorious not because it includes a series of patriarchs and kings, but because it gives the genealogy of Jesus and Mary. He stands in the shadows and supports his son and Mary. He did not boast about his nobility, even though he could have, but lives a simple life of a carpenter. So, in him, God was pleased to exalt both nobility and the labor of an artisan. He is a question mark for all of us who often call ourselves noble and occupy high. Let us pray to Saint Joseph to fill us with humility and simplicity. Thank you.